Potassium, definitely another one of those. And again, back to balance, echoing Jerry's comments about balanced nutrition. So starter P and K, or deep banded or side banded nutrients. At the end of the day, pulse crops comprise a significant amount of protein and starch, and roughly 40% protein, 20% starch in the seed. We need nitrogen, and that's typically one that a lot of folks, well, we got nitrogen fixing bacteria that are going to help us with the nitrogen part, but we still need sulfur, and phosphorus and potassium are going to be a component of ensuring that seed quality. So very, very important to include this as part of the conversation with regard to nutrition on pulses.
I'd like to jump in on that potassium. I know in my area we do have some peas that get put under irrigation, and when you do that, those peas will just get 5 feet tall sometimes. And when they get that tall, it's really hard to do anything to reduce lodging on pulses. But we have seen some benefits for sure, getting that potassium in there. We just don't have enough available potassium in our soils, and we need to make sure that we're giving them a soluble form. Even spraying like a foliar potassium in season, we have seen some benefit getting that foliar potassium in and helping those plants stand. Because at harvest, if there's 3 feet laying on the ground, it's not a lot of fun. So if you can even get another foot of that standing, it significantly improves how they're pulling that crop off the field at the end of the season.